Hello, dear engineers and technocrats. Today's session will enable you to define lifetime related functions for Webull distribution as well as for exponential distribution. You will also learn how to sketch the bathtub curve and describe it. Now we learn how to determine the product lifetime related functions in earlier sessions. So this is failure density function, which gives you the probability of failure at different times. When we integrate this failure density function, we get failure distribution function. It is basically cumulative failure density function. When we subtract this failure distribution function from 1, we get reliability function. And this hazard rate function is determined by finding the ratio of probability density function to reliability function. When we integrate the reliability function from 0 to infinity, or you can say area under the reliability curve, gives you mean time to failure. So these are important lifetime related functions. Now in today's session, we will discuss how we can determine all these functions when time to failure data follows either Webull distribution or exponential distribution. So let's first discuss how we can determine an appropriate distribution for time to failure data. So for that, we put large number of identical and independent components for some operations under specified conditions, and for each component we determine the time to fail data. So you see that this time to fail data, time to failure data, will take different values, and it will behave as a random variable. Now for this time to failure data, we can fit an appropriate distribution by using chi-square test, or we can also use some statistical software such as Minitab, SysStat, and other software available in the market. Now for best fit distribution, we can reliability lifetime functions. So when we fit a appropriate distribution, we get some parameters for that particular distributions, and these parameters defines the probability density function of a probability distribution function. For example, when we fit a distribution for time to failure data, and best fit distribution is found to be Webull distribution, then for Webull distribution we get the values of its parameters. Now two important parameters of Webull distribution are beta, that is also known as shape parameter, and neta, that is also known as scale parameter or characteristics life. Now this characteristics life is the time period at which 63.2% of the failure takes place. Now when we put these value of scale parameter and shape parameter in this failure density function of Weibull distribution, we get probability of failure for given value of type. So this expression is the failure density function for Weibull distribution. Depending on the value of shape parameter beta, the hazard function can be increasing, decreasing, or it may remain constant. When beta is equal to 1, we observe a constant hazard rate function. Hazard rate function is increasing when beta is greater than 1, and hazard rate function decreases when beta is less than 1. When beta is less than 1, reliability decreases sharply and monotonically, whereas when beta is equal to 1, reliability decreases monotonically but less sharply than beta is less than 1. For beta is greater than 1, reliability decreases gradually with time. As wear out sets in, the curve goes through an inflection point, and thereafter reliability decreases sharply. Similarly, you see that scale parameter of Weibull distribution also has significant impact on failure function. You see that if scale parameter neta is increased while holding shape parameter beta constant, the distribution gets stretched out to the right and its height decreases. Now, this is the probability density function of Weibull distribution, which gives you probability of failure for different values of time. Now, when we integrate this failure density function from 0 to t, we get the failure distribution function. And when we subtract this failure function from 1, we get reliability function. So 1 minus 1 plus this thing, so 1 will cancel out, and you will get reliability expression like this. We know that hazard rate function is the ratio of failure function to reliability function, so these terms will cancel out each other, and we will get this term. So it will be the hazard rate. Now you put the value of beta here. When you put the beta is less than equal to 1, the hazard rate will decrease with time. When we put beta is equal to 1, the hazard rate will remain constant. And when we put beta is equal to greater than 1, hazard rate will increase with time. We can find out mean time to failure by multiplying scale parameter and taking gamma function of 1 plus 1 upon shape parameter. We can also find expected number of failure by time t using this expression. So from failure density function, you know how to determine the remaining function, and by fitting best fit distribution we can find all these parameter of Wabul distribution. In previous slides we observed that for the Wabul time to failure distribution, a plot of hazard function over time follows three patterns, namely decreasing pattern, constant pattern, and increasing pattern. Now, depending on the failure mechanism, the hazard function of a system may follow any one pattern at a time, or a combination of any two patterns, or all the three patterns. When we plot hazard function versus time, and if a system consists all three distinct patterns, then such a plot is called bathtub curve, because its shape resembles the profile of a bathtub curve. So a bathtub curve is a curve between hazard function and time. It starts with early failure region where hazard function decreases with time. This is also known as burn-in period or infant mortality period. In this phase, weak items are weeded out, and we can observe this infant mortality phase for most of the electronic items. Poor manufacturing processes, wrong handling and packaging, incorrect installation or setup, and power surge are few reasons of early failure. The early failure region is followed by a relatively constant hazard rate function. It is known as useful life period. Insufficient design margins and use of items outside the specified environment and human error causes the failure during this period. Useful life period is followed by a wear out region. An increasing hazard rate is shown by repairable items when wear out starts as a result of weakening of strength due to cyclic loading and material fatigue. So you may note that during infant mortality period, beta is less than 1. During useful life, beta is equal to 1, and during wear out phase, beta is greater than 1. So throughout the useful life, hazard rate remains constant, And when hazard rate remains constant, we can assume, or when beta is equal to 1, Webull distribution turns to exponential distribution. Now, how we can calculate lifetime functions under exponential distribution? The failure density function under exponential distribution is given by this relationship lambda e to power minus lambda t, where lambda is the failure rate. The exponential probability density function is always convex and it is stretched to the right as lambda decreases. The value of probability density function is always equal to the value of lambda at time t is equal to 0. So when lambda is 0.005, at t is equal to 0, we put here t is equal to 0, so probability density function will be equal to lambda. Now, from this probability density function of exponential distribution, when we integrate this ft from 0 to t, we get the failure function. And when we subtract this failure function from 1, we get the reliability function. So, failure function is 1 minus e to power minus lambda cross t. And reliability comes out e to power minus lambda t. So from now onwards, when exponential distribution would be given, we will use this formula to get the reliability. When you know that hazard rate function is the ratio of failure density function to reliability function. So when this lambda e to power minus lambda t is divided by e to power minus lambda t, we get hazard rate function is equal to lambda, and since lambda is a constant, so under exponential distribution this hazard rate remains a constant throughout the life of a product, and this is constant failure rate or hazard rate is observed during the useful life of the product, as we just now seen in the bathtub curve. And mean time to failure is the area under the reliability curve, or it is simply the reciprocal of failure rate or hazard rate. So in exponential distribution, we hazard rate is known as failure rate, and expected number of failure are given by lambda multiplied by t. So from given probability density function, we can determine all reliability related function for exponential distribution. And for different values of t, if lambda or failure rate is given, we can determine the probability of failure from this relationship. If you find this session useful and interesting, please hit the like button, share the session with your friends, and subscribe it. Thank you all for patience hearing, liking and sharing this video, and subscribing my channel Industrial Engineering Guru.